Okay, welcome and thanks for listening to my talk. Today I'm going to talk about emotions in Homo and Pan. So emotional expressions, there's not one single day passing by without having them. When expressing emotions, conspecifics can attend to those emotions, right? Emotions attract our attention immediately. And also they tend to be mimicked by others. And there's a lot of literature showing positive relationships between mimicry and social decisions. Emotional expressions have benefits for the expressor, but also for the perceiver. For example, there's direct perceptual benefits. Susskind and colleagues have nicely demonstrated that when widening the eyes in fear, this has direct perceptual benefits for perceiving the visual field better. But also when you express emotions, you can get support from others. Mimicking expressions by observers also has several benefits. First of all, you can probably understand the other person better when you're mimicking. And also, it may give you the same perceptual benefits. So when, for example, you're in an environment and there's a predator approaching you and you widen your eyes in fear and you can actually perceive the predator better, this, of course, has the same benefits for the individual standing next to you. In our work, we are comparing different species of great apes. Actually, we're comparing humans, chimpanzees, bonobos, and orangutans, and the gorilla is still on my list. And we are doing that because we hope that by doing so, we can get some evolutionary understanding of where our expressions come from and why they evolved the way, the way they are. So I'd like to take you to this little green box here, and that is attention. Emotions capture our attention. There's a wide literature on that in humans. But there was no study at all looking at attention in the bonobo, our closest living relative. So what we did here in the study, non-invasive study in the zoo, is we let bonobos take part in a dot probe paradigm. So what we did, we showed them hundreds of different photos of social emotional behaviors and found that when they tapped on a dot that replaced such an emotional scene as compared to a neutral scene, they were faster simply because their attention was dragged to the emotional expressions, just like is the case in humans. My PhD student, Evie van Berlo, took this a step further because she was wondering, well, you know, those bonobos, they're watching unfamiliar bonobos on the screen. What happens if they see their own groupmates? We replicated the attentional bias in unfamiliar individuals. So bonobos immediately attend to the emotional expressions in the scene. But this effect disappeared when they were looking at their kin and kith. They were as attentive to the neutral as to the emotional images. We found a similar, though not significant, effect when bonobos watched human expressions. Interestingly, she also tested humans. So as I said, this was a study conducted at the zoo, and in the zoo you don't only have non-human animals, you also have human primates, the visitors. And typically in a zoo, visitors come with their friends and their family. So what Avi did was she took pictures of the visitors and asked them to pose emotional expressions. And she took photos of that, which she immediately used in her experiment when she tested the friend of the family member. What she found was the opposite of what she found in bonobos. So humans have an attentional bias towards the emotional expressions, especially when expressed by familiar others. And this gives us to think about our experiments, which we typically use in psychological science. In typical experiments, we see unfamiliar people on the screen, the faces of Paul Ekman, for example. I don't know those people. So maybe this is something to consider in our own research. So why do humans attend more to the expressions of familiar others and bonobos to the expression of unfamiliar others? I'd like to give you an evolutionary explanation. It's very speculative, but I think it's important to think about this question, why we find what we find. So if you look at the small red area in the middle of Africa, this is the area bonobos live in and where they evolved. It's a relatively speaking safe environment with plenty of food sources, and there's not much competition with other groups of bonobos. Well, chimpanzees in blue, that area used to be a lot bigger, unfortunately, but still you can see it covers a much larger area. And with that increased size, the chimps also were confronted with different environments with unique threats and challenges. They started competing with other chimpanzee groups over scarce food sources. Well, this is not unfamiliar to us humans, right? We fare wars as well as chimpanzees. And humans cover a much wider area. So this may be why humans are so much attuned to their own in-group. And bonobos are actually really interested in individuals that they don't know. We're now also measuring sustained attention via eye tracking. And we find again that bonobos' attention is captured by the emotions of other bonobos. So when I'm talking about emotional expressions, I'm not just talking about the six basic expressions by Paul Ekman. Expressions are also visible in physiology or in neural correlates. And some of them are also visible from the outside. Take, for example, the blush or the pupil that dilates when we become aroused or emotional. Also in my psychological research, I take emotional expressions which are typically studied in primatology, such as scratching or yawning, very contagious behaviors. In a recent review paper, colleagues and I came to the conclusion that there's actually hardly anything known about how humans express emotions. And this may sound very weird because there is such a wide literature, but much of that literature focuses on posed expressions where actors are trying to look sad, but are not sad, in fact. So what we're now doing in my lab is we're trying to investigate emotional expressions under much more ecologically valid circumstances. And I'd like to take you to a study where we look at emotional expressions and the mimicry and the consequences for social behavior in a blind date experiment conducted at a festival. And this is work by my postdoc Iliska Pohaskova, and it was recently accepted in Nature Human Behavior. So in this experiment, dating partners came in a dating cabin, were seated face to face, and we recorded many different things, different physiological signals, facial expressions, bodily postures. Also their eye tracking behavior was captured with eye tracking glasses. What do you see typically in a date? You see that people will make eye contact and they show a wide palette of emotional expressions, facial expressions and bodily expressions, and those tend to be mimicked. And this was also the case in our study. As you can see in the little circles, those are correlations between behaviors. So those were very high. People were mimicking and synchronizing with each other. But this smile that you see on this picture, what does it mean? Does it really mean happiness? Is it a positive signal? Maybe she doesn't really like him and she's trying to apologize for that. Or maybe he is very nervous. So this can have very different meanings, right? In fact, women tended to smile a lot, and men were typically interpreting that the wrong way. The key question is, what is it good for, the mimicry of all these behaviors? Did it help? In fact, it did, but only for the subconscious levels. So specifically, The synchronization in physiology was positively related with mutual attraction and dating success, but the mimicry of smiles not so much. So this shows that it's really important to look at emotions at different levels. We recently replicated this study in the lab where participants played a prisoner's dilemma game, and we showed that physiological synchrony has positive consequences for cooperative success. Finally, I'd like to show you one more experiment, because this relationship between mimicry and social behavior, is that always positive? What about if we mimic negative expressions of emotion? This is work by my PhD student Fabiola Diana, and she wanted to compare humans interacting face-to-face via video call, for example, like Skype, or while watching a pre-recorded video. And she focused on four behaviors, two target behaviors, yawning and scratching. And these are two behaviors that are typically studied in primatology and which can be found in stressed situations, also in humans, actually. So participants were sitting face-to-face, or they were sitting face-to-face but with a screen in between, and the participants were then seeing each other on a computer screen. And they were either seeing each other live, like in a Skype call, or they were actually seeing a pre-recorded video of the confederate of the previous participant interaction. And they were playing a trust game after each interaction. What she found was that mimicry occurred independent of the specific behavior. So all four behaviors were highly mimicked, and they were mimicked as much in the live face-to-face interaction as through the Skype call, let's call it that way. And it was not so much happening during the pre-recorded video, although it was also happening there. Then there was a difference also in the behaviors that were being mimicked. So the scratching was most contagious. It's really contagious. When I'm talking about itch, or when I'm scratching, it's very likely you start to feel itchy as well. Interestingly, what she found was that the more those behaviors were mimicked, so the scratching and the yawning, the less actually they trusted the confederate in this experiment. So the mimicry of behavior does not always have positive consequences. It can have negative consequences as well. Personally, I think that by mimicking another person, you start to understand that other person better. You can better place yourself in his or her shoes, for the better or for the worse. But to conclude, emotional expressions have multiple functions for the expressor and the perceiver. They are attended to immediately, and they hold attention. Expressions are mimicked on several levels, influencing social decisions to trust, to cooperate, or to date someone again or not. And species differences may be explained by the unique environmental pressures they were confronted with on their unique evolutionary pathways. Thank you for your attention.